Myself, Dr. Deepti Jain, gynecologist. Today, we will be discussing about the various instruments used in the procedure DNC. DNC is a very commonly done procedure in gynecology and obstetrics. DNC stands for dilatation and curettage. The most common two indications in gynec and obs is basically in gynecology, it is used to diagnose the causes of abnormal uterine bleeding. That means we take endometrial biopsy by the procedure dilatation and curettage. And in obstetrics, it is mainly done to convert an incomplete abortion into a complete one or for the termination of the pregnancy. So today we will be discussing in detail about the various instruments used in this procedure. Coming first with sponge holding forceps. So this is a sponge holding forceps, as you can see. Basically it is used for painting. We paint with the help of betadine the vaginal and the perineal area with the help of this sponge holding forceps. After that, we take this speculum. This is Sims speculum. See, Sims speculum, these are available in three sizes: small, medium and large. Depending on the size of the vagina of the female, whether she is a nulligravida or multigravida, according to that we use the instrument. It is a double bladed speculum. These are two blades. Single bladed Sims speculum is also available, although this is a double bladed Sims speculum which is commonly used. This handle, the mid part, which is the handle of the Sims speculum, you see it has a curvature. Basically this curvature or curved ends is to prevent any injury, any lacerations to the vagina. You can see depth also there in the handle. This is here also as some indentation or depth you can see. This is for the so that the liquid may dribble through this and it may not spill over. So basically this is the Sims speculum, which is mainly used to retract or depress the posterior vaginal wall. So first, after doing painting, we put this Sims speculum inside the vagina. We just make it enter it like this, then we rotate it in 90 degree angle and we depress the posterior vaginal wall. After depressing the posterior vaginal wall with the help of this Sims speculum, the next instrument which comes in use is Valsalum. This is a multi-tooth Valsalum. Single-tooth Valsalum is also available, but usually we are using a multi-tooth. You can see there are multiple tooths over there. Multiple-tooth Valsalum, it is used to hold the anterior lip of the cervix. With the help of this tooth, we hold the anterior lip of the cervix and we retract it upwards, right? After that, we take our uterine sound. See, all these are metallic instruments. This uterine sound, it serves two purposes. One, it helps in seeing the direction of the uterus. We can see it's an antiverted uterus or retroverted uterus. We can know with the help of this instrument. There are markings over here, as you can see it, and these help us in knowing the length of the uterine cavity, so that the further next instruments which we are putting, before that we should have a rough idea that what is the length of the uterine cavity. And it also acts as the first dilator. So with the help of this uterine sound, we see whether the uterus is antiverted or retroverted. We look for the length of the uterine cavity and it acts as a first dilator also. Now coming to the dilators, this is a set of Heggar's dilators. You can see there are increasing number of dilators. So its numbering is from 1 to 11 millimeter. See, over there it has two ends. Both sides act as dilators. One is smaller one and the other one is a bigger one. The numbering is overwritten here, which tells about the diameter of this dilator. Number 1, 2. So one is a smaller one and two is the larger one. The increasing number of dilators, we introduce obviously the thinnest one first and then we use gradually increasing number of dilators, with the help of which we are able to dilate the internal loss so that our next instruments can enter into the uterine cavity. So these are the increasing size. This is bigger, then it's the more bigger one, like this. This gradually increasing number of dilators. After putting these dilators, when we reach to the required dilatation of internal loss, we use this ovum's forceps. See, this ovum's forceps is a typical instrument. It doesn't have any catch. If you see, it doesn't have any catch. This is specifically made without catch so that it doesn't cause any trauma to the uterine wall. If by chance it grabs some uterine tissue, then also it's not going to harm. It's not going to cause any trauma because it doesn't have any catch. There are serrations also over here, upper end. These are actually made to prevent crushing of the fetus. The conceptors which we are removing, it prevents the crushing. So we enter to the internal os. We put the ovum's forceps in the uterine cavity. With the help of rotational movements, we remove the internal products out, right? So after completing the process with ovum's forceps, then comes the use of this uterine curette. If we are using it for, we are doing the endometrial biopsy for gynec purposes, that means just to know the cause of uterine bleeding, then definitely ovum's forceps will not come in the picture. We will directly use uterine curette. Uterine curette may be both ends sharp one, or one sharp and one blunt end. So sharp end is usually used in gynec procedures, so when the uterus is relatively hard, and soft one, the soft curette part is mainly used for obstetric purposes, so when we see that the uterus is soft one, right? So with this help of the curette, we curette the uterine cavity. Nowadays, instead of using typical DNC procedure and using ovum's forceps for the abortion procedures, we prefer to use suction evacuation, which is technically less invasive and can cause lesser trauma. So we use Karman's cannula for that purpose. Karman's cannula are actually made of plastic. If you see, this is a plastic cannula, and we attach our suction machine here. At this end, we put our suction machine, and this end we put inside the uterus, and after dilating the uterine cavity, and then we rotate it, and also anterior and posterior movements and back and forward movements. This helps in removing the conceptus, and this is going to give very far lesser trauma as compared to our metallic instruments, and this end also acts as slight curette also. So suction evacuation is now more preferably or commonly used procedure in obstetric purposes, definitely not in gynec procedures, but in obstetric procedures, this Karman's cannulas, which are available in various sizes, these are more commonly used. Karman's cannula are used according to the weeks of pregnancy. Say if it is a 6-week pregnancy, then usually we use number six Karman's cannula, right? So nowadays these are more preferred ones because these cause lesser trauma. If you have any more questions or confusions regarding the instruments used for DNC procedure, you can definitely write us down in the comment box section, and can subscribe the channel for further such information. Thank you.